Hi, good evening.
How are you doing today?
Yeah, I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm also good. Thanks for asking.
So I just have a few questions to
Okay,
ask you.
sure.
And yeah, if you are comfortable, then we can go ahead with it if you don't have any problem.
Definitely.
Thank you, Nilanjan. So I just wanted to know, my first question is this. A lot of students are very concerned about learning grammar when it comes to speak English.
Okay.
So, I already made a video about it and I asked them not to focus on grammar that much. Because if you want to speak English well, grammar is not something about which you should be concerned. I mean, you can learn the concepts, but you need not to dig deeper. What do you think about it?
Well, I think if you are traveling to a different city in a different country, where let's say you want to learn English only for the sake of travel, and you will travel occasionally, or rather, not sorry, not occasionally, rather rarely. In that case, grammar doesn't matter much, because as long as you are able to get your idea across to the other person, it's fine. You are a tourist over there. You're not going to stay there. You're not going to work there. So it doesn't matter as much. If you are trying to learn English because it's for work-related purposes, for example, or maybe because you want, for whether it's for academic purposes or for work-related purposes, then grammar is somewhat relevant, rather quite relevant, because if you grammar is a foundation of how you form, sentences in English. And if you do not know grammar all that well, let's say you don't know when should you use a simple past tense versus when should you use the past continuous tense. And if you don't know those things, those basic things, and if you don't have a good command over that part of the language at least, then you may not be able to get your ideas across to the other person properly.
Exactly. So that was all my point, that if you're going ahead with this language professionally and if you're preparing yourself for any sort of exams, for example, competitive exams or for any exam, then grammar is something which you need to learn because
Yes.
you will have these questions in your question paper, right? Which you need to
Right.
fill. But apart from that, if I am learning spoken English, then I should focus on that part, right?
Yeah.
And okay, so my second question is this: how can we improve our English pronunciation?
I can only advise, I can only tell you what I have done to improve my pronunciation, which is listen more and more. As much as possible, I try to listen and imitate the pronunciation that is already standard. So something simple that the students can do is they can go to google.com, and let's say somebody wants to know how to pronounce the word remote, remote. So they can just go to Google and type remote space pronunciation, and they will have three variants of the pronunciation, at least in India. One is the Indian variant, one is the British English variant, and one is the American English variant. Now,
Exactly.
here comes the tricky part. Traditionally, from school at least, for my case, I have been told to follow British English. So that's what schools do. But then,
We
if you're learning English for work purposes and your clients are in USA, it doesn't make much sense to follow the British English. You would be better off learning the American way of speaking things. So in that case, focus on, choose a particular English variant and learn how the word is pronounced in that particular variant of English. And I
Exactly.
think that's if that is especially if somebody points out that the way you are pronouncing this word is incorrect, or if somebody says a word differently than what you are used to speaking or hearing.
Yes, exactly. So I think if somebody is going ahead with the Indian accent, what do you think? What's the importance of this accent? I mean, people are very confused. I mean, a lot of students, they don't give importance to Indian accent that much. They are very crazy about learning British accent and American accent. You see, so I get this question a lot of times that please tell me what should we learn, British accent or American accent? And my answer was that, see, British accent is widely accepted. Wherever you are going, they will accept you. But it's up to you if you think that you need American accent, as you told, that if I need American accent because I know that I'm working with the clients, then I should learn that accent, right? But what do you think that does this? Indian accent have its own importance, and what's the importance of Indian accent?
Firstly, I don't believe that there is just one accent to call Indian accent, because the people from, let's say, Kerala speak differently than people from West Bengal. So everybody is an Indian and everybody has a different accent. And if you traditional, like if you watch a particular show, any show, Hollywood show or something, or maybe if you search on Google for different pronunciations, you are likely to hear pronunciations recorded by somebody from one of those southern states. So it's kind of misleading to just, you know, categorize that as Indian accent. But speaking of Indian accents, different accents that people have, I think it's fine to have an accent, as long as that accent doesn't make it difficult for somebody else to understand what you are trying to say. Like I had a friend who had a very strong Tamil accent. I studied in Bangalore and I had a friend who had a very strong Tamil accent, and we could not follow what he was saying. We could not understand what he used to say.
Because of the MTI.
Yeah, definitely. Mother tongue influence is one of those, yeah. So if you are able to communicate, get your ideas across, and the other person understands what you are saying, and you don't have clients, you know, you don't have a clear reason for learning the British accent or the American accent, it doesn't make much sense to spend time or spend your effort learning those accents accordingly.
Yeah, that's great. Thank you. Nice to talk to you, Nilanjan.
It was nice talking to you too. Take care.
Good night.
Good night. You too. Have a nice evening ahead. Thank you.